Man, oh man, it look like the pettiness to DaniLeigh just don't have no end. Listen, listen, she back at it again. DaniLeigh, she don't want to see nobody. She don't want no black woman to shine. She don't want no black woman in her interview. Nah, let me stop, man. Jimmy Gaines, the Army, the Navy, the Unstoppable. We back with some more gossip, yeah? Listen. Ladies and gentlemen, I ain't gonna lie. I'm starting to think DaniLeigh is just unconfrontational. Listen, so DaniLeigh got Kendra G pulled. Well, she tried. She attempted to get Kendra G pulled off the morning show, the 107.5 in Chicago morning show, which I'm pretty sure she's a primary host on. So, Kendra G had to give her version of the Donkey of the Day, which is the Goofy Ass Person of the Day award, which I'm not mad at. Listen, we're going to let you hear Kendra G's point of view, and I'm going to jump in with my opinion in the end. Let's go.
This Goofy Person of the Day award goes to DaniLeigh, and let me tell you why. DaniLeigh is in the city of Chicago. I don't know why. Probably got a high school appearance. Who the hell knows? But she was set to do an interview with the morning show, and she requested that I, Kendra G, be removed from the interview because she was uncomfortable talking to me. Girlfriend, this ain't wilding out. You ain't gonna be Simone me. Now your whole interview has been canceled, but I'm trying to figure out, why didn't you want to talk to me in the first place? I actually been on the radio defending your honor. I really felt the way when your baby daddy played you on that infamous IG Live and I defended you on the radio. Now, shout out to B. Simone, who I know in real life, rock with in real life, but I actually understood why you didn't want to do wilding out with her. But I'm still trying to figure out, why the hell you ain't want to talk to me? Now, are you nervous? I'm going to ask you the questions that need to be asked. Like, are you still sleeping with your baby daddy after he beat your brother up and played you on the IG Live? And you know what? I probably would have asked you that question because I need to know. Because if you forgave him, that means I need to forgive him. Are you nervous I was going to bring up that Jello Bone song? Girlfriend, I don't care. You can make a song about your skin tone and celebrate it. I love being a dark-skinned woman. Ain't no wacky like that gonna make me insecure about my complexion. Are you nervous that I was gonna ask you, like, how did it feel to be a girlfriend thinking you was better than all the baby mamas just to become a baby mama and get treated worse? And you know what, DaniLeigh, I probably would have asked you all those questions because guess what? That's my job. That's what I do. I ask the questions that the people want to know. Maybe you should focus on your job, be in the studio and make a hit, and we got to talk about your music and not about your personal life. That's not my fault that your personal life is more relevant than your music. That's your fault. You around here trying to get people removed from interviews. It don't go down like that. Now you missed out on an opportunity to have a radio interview on number one urban station in Chicago. And guess what? This opportunity might not come around again because your music ain't popping. So with that being said, sit your ass down. Enjoy Chicago while you're here.
All right, y'all. So there you have it, man. As you can see, like I said, DaniLeigh back at it again. I'm starting to think she's just unconfrontational, bro. She don't like to be in spaces with people who might challenge her at all. Like, she don't want to talk to somebody who a conversation might be a challenge. Like, you know, some people, I mean, I don't know her personally, but this is what I'm getting from this. The fact that she don't want to, like, even have a debate. Because Wildin' Out was the kind of show where if you go on with somebody that you don't like, if you got good jokes and you witty, you can have a good time whooping their ass at joking on them. And this show right here, if you able to sit down and have a good interview, you should be able to, you know, be accountable of your words and hold yourself, you know what I mean? And say, basically, just compose yourself correctly, you know what I mean? Like, but obviously, she don't know how to hold a conversation that's going to represent herself in the right way, so she didn't want to have Kendra G on the line with her, you know what I mean? I mean, it's clear to me, I could tell. And then, also, this is the type of person that DaniLeigh had to be, if you ask me back in the day. She had to be one of them girls that, like, you know how when you and your crew about to get into a fight with another group of people and you just give one person all your jackets and your book bags, like, yo, hold this, because they're not going to do nothing. You know they're not going to fight. They're unconfrontational. They really don't even want to be there. So they're just going to hold everybody's stuff. They're just going to hold your stuff down. Hold, you know what I mean? All the goodies, anything that you don't want to get beat up while you fighting in combat. And then when you come back, you're going to be like, yo, you know what I'm saying? Yo, give us the play-by-play. The person who never fought could always give you a good play-by-play. Like, so what was happening while we was fighting? Like, while you was holding all the coats and book bags and stuff and you was looking at us, what was happening? Like, give me a play-by-play of the fight. You know what I'm saying? Like, that person is always good to give you a play-by-play. You feel me? But listen, man, that's what it looked like to me. I'm just giving you my opinion, ladies and gentlemen. Jimmy Gang, I'm telling you, this just, what y'all think? Tell me in the comments what you think about this. Is DaniLeigh right for telling all of these people she don't want them in her interviews, and she could just, like, just demand people not be, people that work where they supposed to work, they just don't show up to work the day that she come because she demands it? Or, like, is she wrong for it? What you think? I ain't gonna lie. At this point, it's two people and two black queens at that. I'm not feeling it. I don't like it. You know what I'm saying, bros? Listen, all my brothers that's watching this, give me your opinion too. I don't just want the ladies' opinions. Ladies, put the opinions in the comments, you heard? But fellas, give me your opinion too, bro. If it was a dude doing this, how you feel about it? Because if it was a dude doing this, we'd be saying he a straight bitch. Straight ass. You pussy. You. What, you can't hold yourself? You not good with your words, my boy? You don't know how to express yourself, my boy? You scared? Huh? You scared? Yeah, you gotta be scared. Listen, I guess because she... I ain't gonna lie, I'm gonna hold her accountable, but I guess maybe the ladies might let her get off with this. I don't know. Y'all let me know in the comments if y'all let her get off with this. I feel like we gotta hold every human accountable. So at this point, I'm holding you accountable, DaniLeigh. But we off this nasty. I'm coming at you with all the news. You know the vibe. Subscribe. Make sure you subscribe, like the video, comment, help us get to the algorithm. I'm off this nasty. I'll see y'all in the next one. Vlogtober is in session. Go watch some videos. Me and my bros, me and my shorty, me and my peoples getting lit, having a good time. You know what I'm saying? Sometimes the videos in the hood. Never know what you're going to get.